Resolution drives opportunity.
All of our customers, doesn't matter who they are, we involve them right from the beginning of how products should be. Are the things that they're using now, could it be improved? But this user group was to just get that clarified to say, well, we've got all this feedback, so can you tell us whether, is this really important? Is this number two? Is this how we work? Just to make sure that we are on the right track. And what else do we need to do in the future?
So phase one cameras are amazing. It's calibrated very well, very high resolution, best resolution on the market.
You know, as a standalone system, it's great because it's super flexible. You just connect several cameras together and all of a sudden you've got a large format camera. That's not something that you can find anywhere else in the industries.
The quality of the imagery that we get out of our phase one camera systems is superior than to anything we've seen, and also what we see from competitors out in the market as well.
Well, I stuck with phase one because of three reasons. One was high resolution, high image quality, and high reliability. When you turn the system on, it works.
I think that's super important that we have a what I would call constant feedback loop from what the customers are doing with our tech, and that helps us also then to go the next steps to develop the next type of cameras, components, and so on.
Already actually very excited as product manager that I'm be given here the chance in this round to introduce our newest development.
So one of the things I love doing with phase one products is really looking at non-traditional routes of working with geospatial and three-dimensional data. 3D technology is advancing quickly for creating 3D models. It's not only good for, you know, city planning or mapping, like in the traditional sense, you can use that data to virtually visit without ever stepping foot there. One of the examples is a phase one camera to 3D model Disneyland. So we have an entire 3D model Disneyland that could be used for many different purposes.
You have to have high resolution data to create the kind of the table setting for everything else to be put on top of it.
It's surprising about the amount of effort that they're putting in their R&D to improve the product, because there's nobody pushing them.
When we get feedback from direct customer contact, we're more flexible of implementing those changes and requirements. A couple of them actually we already are working on.
Let's say we wanted to drop the Eiffel Tower into Hong Kong. You know, I just grabbed a model, you know, off of Sketchfab, sized it and put it in.
So being able to put five cameras or even eight cameras into what we call a pod has made it more efficient. We're mounting all of those cameras on one optical bench with the IMU, with the LiDAR system, with the phase one cameras, so that with one IMU, we can geo-reference all of the images together. That alone creates an efficiency to be able to create products for multiple markets at the same time.
I remember there's so many things you said, I need to do this, I'm coming for the film. You have done it and you make our life very exciting. So thank you very much, really appreciate it.
So we felt we had to, with the user group, get everyone involved. And therefore the main thing was to thank the presenters. So the awards were there for things that had happened from phase one, from since I've been over here in the US since. It was just that little to say thank you in front of everyone for doing something with us. Because that's the whole point, working in collaboration, listening to customers, listening to suppliers, saying, how do we make this a little bit better? We can't do it on our own. We have to do it together.